I'm here with Jeremy Watkins so we can talk a little bit about forest operations here on the Malcolm Knapp Research Forest. Jeremy, can you talk just a little bit about what your role is at Malcolm Knapp and what kinds of things you do here?
Certainly, yeah. So my technical role here is as an operations forester. And so I work with colleagues here to plan forestry operations to completion. And so one of the things we're going to talk about today is the operations aspect of two neighboring blocks here and how they are different and the things we have to think about in when we first walk through the woods and we consider logging in this area.
Okay, so we're standing, from your perspective, in the middle of two cut blocks. There's one behind you, and there's one behind Jeremy and me. Jeremy, can you talk a little bit about what the planning process was for these two harvests?
Certainly. So one of the first things to do is to think about the slope we're on. And so if you recall what slope is in forestry, that's our increase in elevation over a unit of distance. And in our profession, we measure this as a percentage. So, and in the field, we measure it with a tool called a clinometer. And if you recall, 100% slope is not a vertical slope. It is actually 45 degrees slope. So we're measuring anything from zero, which is horizontal, to 100%, which is 45 degrees. And so we need to know that for operations, to know what kind of equipment we're going to use on site, because each equipment has its specific abilities and its limitations, what it can do on certain slopes, and there are cutoffs for that.
Jeremy, what's this area below us has kind of a steep slope off of the road, and then it flattens out a little bit, and mm-hmm. the area behind is a more constant slope, but also relatively steep in one spot, a little bit less steep in the other. Can you tell us what the range of slopes is that we're looking at here?
Certainly, yeah. So right off the road below us here on this block, it falls off kind of more sharply, and we're getting about 35% drop here.
So at the maximum, right at the edge here, about 35%?
Yes, and then it becomes more of like a bowl shape here as it flattens out at the bottom and then actually climbs up towards the very back edge of that boundary there. This one's more of a uniform slope, although there is some concave areas, and we got a ridge line coming down the center here, and then a little bit of a gully in some places. And so these are very important considerations when we think about lines of sight and travel for logs and equipment working in these areas.
This section here seems a little bit steeper. What do you think the slope is here?
This one ranges anywhere from 35 to 50%.
So 50%. So in this section here, a quite steep slope.
Quite steep, yes. Okay. And the other characteristic of these two blocks is this one that we're looking at now, with the steeper slope, has a road access at the top of it. And this one doesn't. This one goes right into timber. And behind that timber, and you probably can't hear it, but there is a river down there called the Alouette River, and it's quite a significant river, and it's in deep downcut canyon just off the edge of that. So
that's something you have to think about. Even though that river is outside of the cut block, it's something that you need to think about when you are planning your harvest prescription for mm-hmm. this.
And that's a big thing for us is the hydrology of the area. So when we first come through and we look at these slopes and we look at the soils that are on those slopes and how much rock and organics and clay and these different kinds of soils, we also are very concerned about where the water is currently traveling so that we're not disrupting that path of water or changing its location and where it's going. At the top side here of the road, we have some defined channels, but generally they're seasonally wet, dry right now. Less flow certainly than the bottom side. The bottom side here gets very wet, and we end up with a flat area down there with very soft soils, a lot more organics. And then all this runs through here and down into that Alouette River. And so a big question for us is what's the source of this water and where is this water being delivered to? And what's dependent on these systems? So the big question we have, especially when building a road, traversing the slope through these this area, splitting these two blocks, is there fish present? And so if there's a lake or any body of water up above supplying water down these streams, we need to know if there's fish in that lake. And if these streams are active areas and part of that habitat, and that there are no breaks or barriers between those habitat and these streams.
So whether they're fish-bearing streams or not makes a big difference in your harvesting approach and
how we cross those streams, mm-hmm. and how close we can harvest to those streams, or if we want to at all, and what considerations we need to make for the values of that stream for the fish.
So Jeremy, can you talk a little bit about the planning for this harvest here?
Certainly, yes. Yeah. So we are laid out with two very different boundaries. And so the boundary below us here was a rectangular shape. So you can see there's kind of straight sides and corners and coming straight up. Behind you is almost like two little funnels, two triangles coming down to the road with broad bases.
Was the layout of this cut block mostly influenced by topography? Was that how those decisions were made for the shape?
Partly topography, and it's partly the equipment chosen to harvest it.